Hey guys, John Thompson, Spring Framework Guru here. Today we're going to take a look at setting up Thymeleaf in our Spring Boot web application. Thymeleaf is a pretty cool templating engine that's come out on the scene lately. It uses a natural template language, meaning that you can take a look at the templates within your browser and see them. So the Thymeleaf tags get out of the way and the browser kind of ignores them, so you can actually see the layout in your browser without actually having to render your templates through an application server like Tomcat or something. So it does help speed up your development time. You can put somebody on those templates that just knows HTML and get them editing it. And then you can render those dynamically using Spring and add in dynamic content to them. It's actually a pretty cool concept. Compared to like Java server pages, JSP looks like HTML, but it's not really HTML. So there's a lot of things that a browser won't understand, and it's not going to render correctly. So that's why we're giving Thymeleaf a try today. So Spring Boot does do some pretty cool stuff for you as far as setting up Thymeleaf. Normally, if you're just using Spring and Spring Mvc, you would have to set up a template engine. But when you add in the Thymeleaf dependency within Spring Boot, Spring Boot knows to create that Thymeleaf template engine for you. So what we're going to do is step through some of the configuration. And I've got the screen up here. Okay, we're going to set up a Thymeleaf template within Spring Boot. And I've checked out the project from the first part in this tutorial series. And what we need to do is set up a directory for this. So Spring Boot is going to automatically look at resources and the directory templates. So I'm going to create that now. And I'm going to create an index template. So I'll just say index.html. We'll add that into Git. Now I'm going to cheat a little bit. I've got my tutorial up and I'm going to just paste in that content. Now we have our index page. Now, the next step we got to do is we need to set up the Spring Mvc controller. Okay, so I'm going to go into here and we'll go ahead and create a new package called controllers. And let's do an index controller. Now, you don't have to name your classes something controller. It's just by convention that we do that. So you could call it whatever you want, but it be nice to your fellow programmers and actually do that. Call it a controller if it's going to be a controller. It's just a commonly followed convention. Now, what actually makes this a Spring Mvc controller is adding in this controller annotation. So the next step is we need to set up a method that's going to handle the web request. And we're going to use the request mapping annotation. And we want everything going to the root of the application to come to this. Now, we want it to render the index template. So we're going to return the template name. So what's going to happen here is when the web request comes in, Spring's going to know that you're requesting the root, just the slash there, and that's the root. And this little method here is going to return the string index. And then Spring is going to go look for a Thymeleaf template called index. And then it's going to render that. So now we're going to run this little example here. So now I'm going to go ahead and run this application using Spring Boot just by IntelliJ clicking run. Now you might see this invalid source release 1.8. Okay, so what's happening here is IntelliJ has picked up the wrong JVM, and I need to go in and tell IntelliJ to use the right JVM. So let's go to my latest version of Java 1.8. So I'm going to say, okay, apply OK. And now let's try running this one more time. Now we're going to go in, now that we have the JVM set correctly, let's go ahead and run this in Spring Boot again. You can see Spring coming up. And now down here, we can see the Tomcat has started on port 8080. So let's go take a look at that. Okay, now if we go into Firefox and go to port 8080, we're going to have authentication required. So what's going on here is we selected to use Spring Security. Okay, and Spring Security is stopping the request. So what we need to do is actually set up Spring Security, and we need to tell it that to allow everything to go through, especially at the index level. So on a later post, we're going to show how to set up Spring Security, but by default, Spring Security is going to block whatever requests that come through because we added it to the Spring Boot project in the last series of the tutorial. Spring Security is stopping us. So let's go ahead and set up Spring Security right now. So I'm going to go back over to IntelliJ. We'll stop the Spring Boot application. Now I'm going to create a package. And this is my personal preference. Is to create a package called configuration, and let's set up a Java class. Okay, so we're going to use Java configuration for Spring Security, and as you may know, we want to use the configuration annotation. So what's going to happen automatically within Spring Boot here is because this is within the same package structure as our Spring Boot web application class, this is automatically going to get scanned and brought in as a configuration file. So going from my web post, we want to extend the web security configurator adapter. And I'm just pasting in from the web post. So now I'm going to configure HTTP security. Okay. And I'm going to say authorize request and setting up an AMP manager. So I'm going to permit all requests going to that root context. So Spring Security, this is like leaving the front door open, basically, with this rule. Like open it up, let everybody come through. So now if I restart Spring Boot, you'll see things go through. You can see Tomcat started again. Let's bounce over to Firefox again, and let's reload this page. Now you can see the Thymeleaf template rendered. It says, hello, fellow Spring Framework gurus. Okay, so we're seeing this web page here, and this is like very vanilla HTML. You can see nothing's really going on here. We haven't applied any styling at all. So you can see it's just a simple web page, very simple HTML. There's no CSS, there's no styling. So this is like right out of the box how Firefox is going to display this. And I would like to dress this up a little bit. So let's make this look a little nicer. And one of my favorite CSS frameworks is Bootstrap. And Bootstrap works nicely with jQuery. So if you're following along on the blog post as well, you can see this is my next step in the post. And we are going to use something called web jars. The web jars is a technology basically that takes Java or JavaScript and CSS resources and allows us to bring them into the project using a Maven POM command. So I'm going to paste in these two dependencies. So now we've set up these two dependencies. This is going to bring in Bootstrap and also jQuery. And now with these, we can add in. Now we're going to go over to the index.html Thymeleaf template, and we're going to bring in these resources. So Now what we got going on here is we are setting up a CDN for runtime. So if we come in and want to view this in Firefox, this resource is going to be utilized. So this is like a public CDN for that. Now when Spring runs this, it's going to pick up the Thymeleaf tag and look at web jars and Bootstrap and bring in that minified CSS. So let's take a quick peek at this. Now we can see the styling changed. So you see before, this is the page before. Now we have Bootstrap CSS applied. So style it up a little bit. So we're not going to be done there by any means. And one thing we want to set up ourselves is our own CSS file. And this would be for any type of overrides that we want to do, common web practice. So we're going to set it up here. So now we'll do that. And any resources that we want Spring Boot to provide for us, we're going to put in a directory called static. So now we have a guru CSS. I don't have any rules that I want to add at this point in time. But now when this runs, any CSS overrides that we want to provide, we can put in this file. Okay, one of the things I've done here is I brought over my Facebook cover. I want to add that to the page. So here's the image from Facebook, my Facebook page. And we are going to style this with some basic Bootstrap CSS. So I just cut and paste this out of the tutorial example. So now I have an image source, and this is relative to where this is at on my hard drive. And then we also have a Thymeleaf command here to render it when it's deployed. So let's take a quick peek at this in Firefox, see how it looks. You can see that it styles the page okay. Now this looks a little bit better than it did before, than just a blank page. So now let's go in and we need to restart Tomcat to pick up the changes that we did. So you can do that by clicking on that little circular arrow. Now Spring Boot is going to recycle and bring Tomcat back up with our changes. You can see that Tomcat's running. We'll jump over to Firefox, refresh the page, and boom, there's our little Spring application. Oh, I did make one mistake here. I did not set up Bootstrap correctly. So my apologies. What I was missing, I only brought over this highlighted portion, but I did not bring over the container. That's a very important part of Bootstrap. That sets up your view portal, so to speak. So I'm restarting Spring again so we can see the changes. And I'll show you what changed here using Bootstrap. So we've got Spring running again. I'm going to jump over, take a look at this. So see how the image is all justified to the left. When we refresh, now we can see it's actually in the Bootstrap container. So Bootstrap is a responsive CSS design. So when I resize the browser, it keeps this perspective. So kind of nice feature of Bootstrap. It'll look nice on any display size. It'll look nice on mobile. It'll look nice on a tablet. So nice, really nice framework to use. Okay, so that concludes this portion of the tutorial series. So I just wanted to show you how to set up Thymeleaf and Spring Mvc. So we now have just a quick review here. So we have our index.html, that's a Thymeleaf template. We have a couple small Thymeleaf commands in there, or tags, that are going to be rendered by the Thymeleaf engine at runtime. We have a Spring Mvc controller that's root to the map, or mapped to the root of the application context. And that controller, all he does is returns a string index. So when a web request comes in, the Spring dispatcher servlet is going to find this guy, say, run index. The index is going to return back the string index, which will map to the HTML. The template index.html. And the final step that we had to do, I showed you what happened. Because we brought Spring Security in, Spring Boot's going to automatically configure that. So we also had to set up a web security configuration and tell Spring Security to let all requests go into the root context. And this concludes this portion of the tutorial. So I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit more about Spring, Spring Boot, and Spring Mvc and how it interacts with Thymeleaf. If you like this, I'd appreciate it if you give it a like on YouTube, and I'd love a little social media love as well. If you could head over to my Facebook page and like that, that'd be awesome. And I hope you stay tuned for the next installment on this. We'll be taking a look at setting up Spring Data JPA, and we'll be using that to get data in and out of the H2 database. And look for that tutorial series soon. This is John Thompson, Spring Framework Guru.